East Rutherford, New Jersey. Tonight, on this fine Thursday night, we've got a good one in store between the Dallas Cowboys and the New York Giants. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. They'll come out in the pistol. They run with a rookie. Here's Elliott. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Speaking of Zeke, get this, partner. 86 yards in week 13 against the Vikings. His lowest total since week 2. 86 yards, that's pretty good.
And a decent portion of that came late in the game when they just wanted to hand him the ball, let him be the closer. And that shows me a guy that's figured things out early in his rookie year, because a lot of the time, young runners get frustrated if the plays don't break early. He hung with it and got his yards late.
And Bryant's got it over the middle. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
3 yards remaining here on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And some room to work. And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. So good for the Buckeyes last year, and he's taken that from the college game, showing some glimpses of it here in the NFL.
How about his last season with Ohio State? Over 1,800 yards. Only one game where he didn't get over 100. Remember, he demanded the ball from then on out. I think they listened to him, and they were smart to do so.
And now they're giving it to him here on the next level. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
That was a good, strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
Now it's the Florida Atlantic alum. This is Alfred Morris. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially, it's no gain on the play, and they'll remain a few inches shy of a first with third down looming. The secondary now for the Giants on third down. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. From the red zone now, Prescott. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. Good to see Witten make that catch. In week 13 versus Minnesota, held catchless for the first time since 2008. It was 130 straight games.
And after the game, he said it didn't matter to him, which I find hard to believe, because there is a certain amount of pride to having that streak. But I think Jason Witten is loving the fact that his Cowboys team is on a roll and has aspirations of a Super Bowl, and that trumped the fact that he didn't catch a football.
On second down, Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation.
We are watching a runner having a really nice game. Carrying it very well. Vision is excellent, but boy, look at the help he's getting. Offensive line, I think they're pretty eager to block for him.
And this will be play number 8 of the opening drive. It's third and short. On third and one, here's Prescott. Deep drop. And Dez has got it. Dez Bryant for the Cowboy touchdown. Dez Bryant, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Dan Bailey now for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Bobby Rainey now to return it. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Here's the former seventh-round pick, Rashawn Jennings. And he will possibly get back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. On the other hand, it will definitely take us to the end of the first quarter of play. On second down, here's Manning. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost two there, and it's third down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Throwing is Manning on third down, surveying the field. Great protection, and he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Fielded at about the 28. It'll go as a 42, make it a 43-yard punt. Six on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And now last drive so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But you know, there was a big time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad.
Is that Woody
Hayes? He would have kissed it on the ground. A 1 yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
This is Elliott. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
One man in the backfield, Elliott. He'll get the football here, and he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They come out here in the eye. Here's Elliott. Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage and that's it. And they'll lose a yard that time and that's going to lead to a third down. Well, there they went blitz defensively, Charles, and things were paved well coming from the linebacker position.
I love the way that you described it, paved well. Oftentimes, the guy who gets home on the blitz, he's going to get all the credit, but his teammates did all the dirty work, right? They ran into people on purpose. They sometimes tugged on jerseys to hold linemen to create space and gaps, and that play finished off root.
And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. It's the big offseason signing from Miami, Olivier Vernon, with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of 7. Now the 6-year man, Chris Jones, on to punt it away. Back deep is Dwayne Harris here. So the Cowboys will punt it on fourth down, as on is the veteran Chris Jones to kick it away. Back deep for the Giants, Dwayne Harris. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went
and
three and out.
And now have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Manning gonna throw. He gets this one to Dwayne Harris. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Now Manning throwing on second down. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard, and it's third and short. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Manning to throw on third and one. Hits his target, the tight end, Will Tye. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
I feel like Eli Manning has just gone from downfield bomber to a guy who can complete everything.
He can hit him underneath now.
Yeah, we just saw that there with that pass completion. The maturity of a veteran taken with the defense will give him.
Manning now on first down. He's got time. And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to sack him for a loss of 6. Manning to throw on second down. Finding time. He's going to sling it. That's caught inside the 20. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. The offense lining up first and 10.
Single receiver, single receiver. Hey, you're on an island over there. Single receiver.
Now whistles here and a flag down. I think a Giant jumped early. Here we go on first and 15. They go play action here on first down. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Can you do any more work or make it more dramatic for not much gain than what we just saw there? Did you see how his toes got down? Tip-tap, tip-tap, got him down. But what did he get out of it?
He sold the sizzle. He just had no steak.
I mean, was it 1 yard?
Yeah, you plays like that, you at least expect a first down there, just 1 yard. Manning to throw on second down. And this is caught at the 8. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. fresh out of downs, and they're at the one. First and goal. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
There's another example of why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse than what they've done so far.
On second down, here's Manning. He's got time in the pocket. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Victor Cruz. As the first half is winding down. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And a little time left on the clock. So on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the first half.
Well,
there's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, where they want to let their return guy touch it.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
One man in the backfield, Elliott. He's going to get the football across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final play of the half, Prescott. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry. This is taken at his four. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. They'll send Beckham alone to the left side. Manning now on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. On first and 10, here's Manning. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down. After that incompletion, I got to ask you, did you watch the Madden Classic this last weekend?
How could you miss it? You had to watch that one. How about Spot Me Please, a.k.a. Taylor Robertson from West Virginia over D. Jones 17-3 in the final? That was a terrific, terrific matchup. But for me, watching it, I felt the intensity. I felt like the NFL playoffs, and the finals felt like the NFL Super Bowl. The broadcast quality was tremendous.
Yeah, it was a big deal. How about spot me, please, after sounding like a coach? And very thankful. There was a lot of good competition. I was fortunate to come out on top.
Yeah, when you get the big check, you have a chance to be real humble about it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Jennings. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on 3rd down and 9. On play action, it's Manning surveying the field. And he's got Will Tye complete. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Fresh set of downs here. Throwing on first down is Manning to Shepard, complete over the middle. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
He's going to let this one go deep. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up 3rd.
I'm laughing to myself because I could just hear in film session, but coach, I was throwing to Odell Beckham Jr. Of course I thought he was open.
They'd love to go deep downfield to him, though. Such a threat.
Yeah, a rare incompletion because most of the time we expect him to actually come up with the catch.
And on 3rd down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Throwing is Manning. It's hauled in by Shepard. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy could be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. Here's Jennings on the toss. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15. The linebacker, Anthony Hitchens, there on the stop.
A lot of people call the toss a probing play to see what they can get against the defense, to see how they adjust and react. Their probing's working pretty well. That was a very nice run.
And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. Now Manning throwing on 2nd down. This will be caught at about the 6. Welcome back now here in East Rutherford. 7-7 is our score. Pretty even matchup so far as we start quarter number 4. Working from the gun, Manning. And that is caught. He's got it for a giant touchdown. Dwayne Harris, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Giants are in for 6. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. Here on first down. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it but was not in bounds. Incomplete.
But I think you have to chalk that one up for the defense there. Someone right on the spot. Excellent coverage. Didn't leave him enough room to come down inbounds, even though he did catch the football.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. One man on the backfield, Elliott. Prescott now. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Cole Beasley, the intended target. Third down here. Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. On third down, it's Prescott. He's got time. Now he's going to go deep down the left side. He's got a man complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
He's got the connection to Cole Beasley. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Here we go. One.
From the red zone now, Prescott to the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Watch 19. Here we go.
To the air again, Prescott. That's complete right around the 8. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
They'll throw again, Prescott, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Terrence Williams, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The New York set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Hits his target, the tight end, Will Tye. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Even score late in the fourth. Let's see if the defense can play within themselves, not give up the big play and contain, and keep this knotted up. They run again with Jennings. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Here we go with second and seven. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Manning the throw on second down. Finding time. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that fell harmlessly to the ground. So third and seven, and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
He's got Cruz complete. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
Well, we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double cover, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I will hear about that from him soon.
Jennings. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. To throw is Manning. The left side throw complete to Adams. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Jennings, and he'll be taken down. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And the eighth play on this drive coming up. Now we it's Jennings. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Ninth play coming up here on this drive. This is third and a yard. This is Jennings. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to take the lead here in the final minute. And Gold is able to put it through. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
Now it's Gold after splitting the uprights to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. It's caught on the right side. Williams. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. And he spikes it with just a shade under a half a minute left. 29 seconds on the clock. Bryant, the lone receiver, left. He's back to throw. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. And now down to 14 as he spikes it to stop the clock. And now the Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And the Cowboys will call on Dan Bailey here. This to potentially send us to overtime. And his kick is good. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. And New York set to take the field. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. They'll give it to him right up the gut. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Now out come the Giants. Tie game, and barring something incredible here, we're likely headed to overtime.
And just a couple of scenarios here to keep in mind. One, if you want to be really aggressive, you do throw the Hail Mary and see if you can get something downfield.
What would you do?
What I would do is either hand it off inside or more likely I take a knee and let the clock run out. Because if I'm back there trying to throw and a sack happens, the ball comes free, I can lose the game here. If I get to overtime, I can still win it.
Let's see if they are in line with Charles Davis. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this one is incomplete. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now.
That throw has to be a quarterback's dream, doesn't it? Big tight end curling in the middle of the field, so it's great sight lines for him. And when they show their numbers back to the quarterback, when they sit down right there, that should be pitch and catch.
Now Manning throwing on second down. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. From the gun on third down, Manning surveying the field. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it. And nobody was open downfield there. Looked like a pretty clear throwaway.
Yeah, definitely was that. I'm wondering why there wasn't intentional grounding. I know they're saying there's a receiver there in the area. Those darn quarterbacks, they get away with everything.
Spoken like a true defensive back, Mr. Davis.
Did that come out?
It did.
Okay.
46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. It's taken to the 26. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to him, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Now part one is done. Now part two. Now Elliott. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. Damon Harrison, the one on the stop.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Here we go.
And what can Prescott do in the OT? Out left side here to Bryant. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. Okay, so now the question, how did he get that wide open?
Well, we both know that he shouldn't, because from the time they handed out scouting reports before this game, he was circled, starred, everything. Find him, cover him. But sometimes you can scheme a guy open. You put the receivers in a bunch. Maybe you move some motion. Maybe you put them on the backside of a formation, and all of a sudden you've got a better matchup. Every now and then, the offensive guys, they figure a way to get him open, even with everyone keeping eyes on him.
And that's certainly a guy they want to keep trying to scheme open. They go to Elliott again. And an alley to run. And he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. And that led to a really nice game.
One man on the backfield, Elliott. He'll get it running right. And he'll take this one down to the 36. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
They run with Morris. And a short gain down to about the 33. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Prescott from the gun on 3rd. And that's caught by Beasley. And he's able to pick up the 1st before he's taken down at the 27.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Down carry by Elliott. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll be down to just 1 remaining as we step aside here in overtime. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Prescott now on 2nd down. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route. And then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
From the red zone now, Prescott. And that's caught. Did he stay in bounds, though? He did not. Ruled incomplete.
I think he might have been a little bit too focused on turning upfield. He didn't stay in bounds. He caught the ball, but he wanted to catch it and run, get that rack yardage so badly, he forgot to stay in bounds first.
Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field.
Come on, let's go!
to the ground with Elliott. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final stoppage here in overtime, and we'll be back. Will the defense dial up the pressure? Let's see. Third and 11.
Here we go. What?
On third down, it's Prescott. Can't find anyone open. That is caught at the 7. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hitting yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Well, partner, even though my phone alarm failed me this morning and I missed our AM workout, we still made it through this thing together, didn't we?
Well, you always know I need extra workouts just to keep up with you.
Come on.
So it doesn't matter, but thanks for sharing a booth and thanks for being our quarterback.
Yeah, you're the quarterback. Always a pleasure, my friend. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more,